Hello everyone, Kelly Cowdevine here playing Football Manager 2017. We're playing with Grasshoppers in the Swiss Super League. And we have played 15 matches so far. That means we have 1, 2, 3 matches left to go in the first half of the season. And after that there will be a break in the league for about 2 months before it restarts again. At the moment we are in the lead, but we have 2 tough opponents today, Basel, Young Boys, and then Vaduz, that is at the bottom of the league. They just left last place, but Lausanne and Vaduz seem to be the teams fighting for relegation. But Basel and Young Boys, very tough opponents. We were gonna take them on today, so let's go! In the previous match, in the previous episode, Caillou got injured. He will be gone for 5 to 6 months. Very big blow to the team, as he is one of the best players on the team. But I feel like we can do well without him. We have Sigur Jonsson and Munoz. Now in the midfield, we move up Andersen to be the attacking midfielder. I feel like we are playing with the best team we can muster today, and hopefully they will perform. In the previous match against the Basel, we played 1-1, and we played surprisingly well away. We surprised ourselves by really being the better team against Basel that time. Hopefully we can do the same this time around. Instructions, we will go with the work ball into the box, but standard and fluid. We can see that we are the small favorite to win today, mostly because we are playing at home. They are playing 4-2-3-1. Should be careful with Dombia. Locatelli is good. Well, they have a lot of good players, so this could be difficult, but I feel like we might be able to at least get a point here. Opposition instructions, we're gonna ask our assistant manager, and that looks fine. Pick up where they left off, I think that will be fine for this match as well. I think that will work for us. We'll skip that. Let's start the game. Come on, guys. I believe in you. So, half time. And there were no highlights at all in the first half. Not sure if that is a good thing. What can we tell the team here? Let's go passionate. We can still come out of this match with a win today. Hopefully that will be beneficial for us. Start second half. Okay, first highlight. Could it be ours? But the Basel goalkeeper had the ball and they are pushing forward. It is going to be a highlight for Basel. And it's a free kick. Runar Mar, Sigur Jonsson might get a red card. He goes hard into the tackle against Dombia, and that is a red card. Let's do that instead. Not good at all. Sophie with the free kick, but it is a poor free kick. You can see we have only had 3 shots and 1 on target, and then we have 4 shots and 1 on target. Oh, we score! Goal! Corner kick, and we score. Sesiger, our defender. Andersen with the corner, and Sesiger goes highest on that ball, and we find the goal. 1-0. One man down, and we managed to score the first goal of the match. And a super uneventful match. The red card was one highlight. Our goal was the second highlight. And that is all we get from the match against Basel. But we win the match. Absolutely amazing that we can win that match. And super boring match overall. You can see that they have 17 shots, 2 on target. We have 8 shots, 2 on target. But we win the match and we distance ourselves with 5 points down to Basel. We and Sion are the only ones that... we and Sion are battling for winning the first half of the season. So Sigurd Jonsson get a red card. He's been banned for one match. Not too bad. I thought it could be worse. But we're gonna fine him 1 week of wages anyway. And he feels it is unfair. I'm gonna tell him something. I'm gonna say that everyone who gets a red card will get a fine. And he was happy with that. We're about to start the match against the Young Boys, but we need to replace Runar Mar Sigurd Jonsson, who will play instead. I feel like it should be Bayrami. Let's put him in. And we need to put someone else in here as well. Patrick Olsson will be on the bench. Do we make any changes from the previous match? I do not think that is needed. Maybe we should replace Rich Mansi, give Gibari another chance to play. But yeah, we're gonna stick with Rich at least for the first half of the match. Munoz Dabur have been slightly injured during the 1 week break from the after the previous match. I think he was injured for 2 to 3 days. And we can see that he's at 94% now condition, but I feel like that should be fine. Tough match away against Young Boys, even if Young Boys have not impressed that much so far this season. It's still a very tough opponent, but let's push into the match. Young Boys playing 4-2-3-1. Feel like we have been playing better against this lineup or this formation now than we did early on in the season. But they have some strong players. Sanago is, I think he's the best player on the team. But he's on the bench today. Not sure why. Maybe he was better in the 2016 version of the game than in the 2017 one. Opposition instructions, we're gonna tell our assistant manager to do that, and that looks fine. Maybe I would like to go hard on the striker as well. There we go. We can put him on the weaker foot as well. And we're gonna go passionate this time. Come on, lads, show me what you can do to keep our run going. That is fine. I would be happy with a draw today. 1 point is more than enough against a team like Young Boys. First chance of the match, first highlight. It is a corner for Young Boys, but it ends up with an own goal. Barmet own goal. Was it Revet with the ball on the... Yeah. That's not good, Barmet. That is actually because you were unthreatened, completely unthreatened. Second highlight, it's also for Young Boys. It's another corner. This time we managed to clear the ball to a throw-in. Third highlight, and this time it is a throw-in for Young Boys. We almost stole the ball, but they managed to get it back, and Soleimani scores 2-0. That is the first shot on goal, first shot on target for Young Boys, and the score for the second time in this match. So half-time, and we are not happy with the performance of our players today. Rich Mansi is actually in worse condition than Munoz Dabur. I need to make changes. Do I have anything I can do? I'm gonna put in Georgiev and move down Andersen, and I need to switch places. Munoz Dabur, you need to improve a lot in this half. Barmet is still only a 6.5, actually worse rating for Sesiger. I thought Barmet would be a lot worse with the own goal. We're gonna tell them like it is. And since Munoz Dabur seems motivated, we're gonna not say anything extra to him. Otherwise, I would have liked to do so. Let's see if we can do better here in second half. First highlight, oh, we steal the ball. Georgiev, Dabur, Antonov. Let's see if we can find anything here in the middle. Mansi, and Mansi scores. Georgiev with the assist. I feel like that was a good move from us to put in Georgiev. I can see that he finds Muncy there, and surprisingly a lot of space for him, and not the best finish, but it is enough. We are back in the match. This highlight, hopefully it will be ours, but it is Young Boys pushing forward. A very poor finish from them. And sadly, this is the end of the match. Don't think we will be able to create anything here in the last seconds. Nope. We take the ball, but the match is over. We lose 2-1 against Young Boys. We should be winning these matches. Make that crystal clear to them. I think that is a good speech to give. And we can see that we had more chances than them. But it was not enough. Not nearly enough. We are still in the lead. Sion also lost today against St. Gallen. So we managed to keep the lead. And actually Basel also lost. Which means we are in a great position. One match left to go for the first half of this season. We're gonna play against Vaduz. So during the mid-season break, we will go on a training camp to Andalusia. There we go. We haven't looked at loan reports so far this season. Florian Camberi, he's not playing anything for Karlsruhe. That is not good. We might want to recall him if that is possible in January. We can also see that Jean-Pierre Reiner is playing a lot for Schaffhausen. I think Schaffhausen is in the second division here. Yes, they are. They are placed in fourth place here. So a lot of good experience for Jean-Pierre Reiner. And he is actually a player that we might use next season for our main team. Noah Lovely, also a good player, playing a lot for Volan, also should be in the second division. Yes, they are. The Swiss Challenge League, also a strong player. We might have use of him next season as well. And Peter Pusic is at Chiasso, also in the Swiss Challenge League. He's been doing very well, 19 matches, but none of them have very good average rating. We can see that Caio is still injured, Sean Valera is also injured, but might be back for the next match. We will see. Not sure if he would be allowed to play anyway. We're going to have a look how it is going for the Swiss teams in the European Cups. Champions League, you can see Basel is ended up in third place with 4 points after 6 matches. They managed to get ahead of Lechia from Poland. So they will go on to the Europa League playoffs. That is actually rather good for Basel. Coming in third place. And also let's go to the Europa League. And Swiss teams around. There we have Young Boys. Young Boys ended up in third place. Lost out to Fenerbahce and Gelsenkirchen. But they beat out Red Star from Belgrade. That is decent by them. And we can also see that Zürich managed to come in third place. Losing out to PAOK and Anderlecht. Time to set up the team for the match against Vaduz. You can see Numa Lavanchi is actually suspended. So Juan Valera needs to play. I said he would probably not get to play anyway, but now we are pretty much forced to have him on the team. What else can we do? We can actually move down Andersen to the midfield and replace Bayrami with Georgiev, because Georgiev actually did well in the previous match coming in from the bench. So we get the chance to start this match, but other than that, Runar Marsigur Jonsson is actually back. Georgiev, that means you might need to lose your position on the field anyway. We are moving it back. There we go. That is probably the best lineup we can produce at this point. And we're gonna play it attacking today, I feel like. Vaduz is last in the league again. same points as Lausanne, but worse goal difference. So I would like us to create a few goals today, playing at home against a weaker opposition. We can see that they are playing 4-1-4-1. Kukuruzovic is of course dangerous. We need to keep an eye on him. Let's see what my assistant manager says. Let's put some extra tight marking on Kukuruzovic. And then we're gonna see what we can tell the team. We're gonna go aggressive. I expect nothing but a win from this match. Really put the heat on the players ahead of this match. Valera hits the ball into the middle. Munoz gathers the second ball. We are keeping the attack going. Are we gonna get an early goal? No, not this time. Instead, it is Faduz with the ball, with the throw-in. Can we take it back? Yes, we can, but Faduz keeps the ball. Looks like this will be a highlight for Faduz. But our goalkeeper, Joel Mahl, easily takes the ball. Munoz, Dabur. Will he find Antonov? Yes, he does. Back to Munoz, and Munoz actually hits the bar. Very good shot from Munoz. Looks like we have taken control of the ball again. Dabur, Andersen. Andersen finds the goal. What the hell? That looked like a rather weak shot, but it finds the post and finds the net afterwards. Goalkeeper was not really doing a good job there. Let's see it again. I should have taken that, but we managed to take the lead, so that is a good thing for us. Highlight directly after the kickoff again. Munoz finds Vansi, Dabur, back to Munoz. Valera turns around and it's a penalty. Axel Borgman trips on Valera, who will take the penalty this time around. It's going to be Dabur, and Dabur finds 2-0. His 17th goal of the season. Dabur have been super important for us. Excellent finish. Mansi with the ball. He needs to hold it up. Oh, that was not good enough. I wanted to tell him to hold up the ball and wait for our other players to join him. Half time, and I want to make one change. I'm gonna put in Gubari, since Mansi have not been impressive so far in this match. Other than that, I feel like we should just continue. First highlight of the second half, 70 minutes played, and we have 3-0. Gubari scores third goal of the season for Gubari. He have not been playing a lot, but when he have played, he have been rather good actually. Well-placed shot and highlight directly after the kickoff for 3-0 goal. Dabur, Munoz pushes forward, finds Gubari and Andersen, and that is an own goal, I think. Yes, it is. Kaufman. Andersen with a good position shoots and it hits the goalkeeper, and there is some weird movements by Kaufman, and he manages to score in his own net. Corner kick and another goal. Gubari scores for the second time in this half. 5-0 with 80 minutes played. Antonov with the corner. They try to head it away, but Gubari finds the ball and finds the net. And that is the end of the match. A very solid 5-0 win. A lot of players did very well today. Gubari, very good in the second half. Dabur with one goal and two assists. We're gonna tell them that we can be proud of that result and the performance to go with it. And this means we will be in the lead of the league. See that we control that match very well. Let's have a look at the season so far. We are now going into the mid-season break. Swiss Cup, we lost out in the quarter final against St. Gallen. We got knocked out by West Ham United in the Europa League qualification. And that is not correct. Let's see if we can see it here. Yes, we can. We are in the lead, 1 point ahead of Sion, 6 points ahead of Young Boys. And we can see that Basel ended the league super poorly, being 8 points behind us now. Let's actually have a look at the... You can see that they lost against us, then against Lucerne, and then against Lugano. That is not a good way to end the season. Not the season, the end the half of the season. First 18 matches played. Let's look at best players so far this season. Average rating, Munas Dabur is in the lead. We also have Lucas Andersen in 4th place, Antonov in 8th place, and Cedric Sessier in 13th place. Doing very well so far. Very interesting prospect, Matej Pulkrab. Is that someone we would be able to acquire? Very expensive, so not sure if that is a possibility. But if we have a chance to do so, we will certainly make an attempt to sign him. Goals, of course, I was going to say that Munas Dabur is in the lead, but we can see that that same Czech player, Matej Pulkrab, have scored 18 goals. Very, very good by him. Average minutes per goal, same thing there. Pulkrab in the lead, Dabur in second place. Key passes, we can see Andersen is up there. Dabur is also doing very well, but it is Marco Sneveli in the lead for Lucerne. Most assists, Lukas Andersen with 8 together with Nsosi Toko for St. Gallen. Pass completion, we are not doing that well here. 87%, I'm super happy with that. But Munoz is the only one from our team on this list. Mistakes leading to goal, we have no one on this list. Mistakes in general, Antonov is high up, Marko Basic, Lukas Andersen are also very high up when it comes to mistakes. Actually, I'm not really happy with Marko Basic this season. Maybe we need to change his role on the team. Interceptions, that's important. Marko Basic is doing well when it comes to interceptions. Sesiger also doing well. Clean sheets, Joel Mall and Marko Vasic have 4 each. And that is rather well, good. Marko Vasic have played 11 matches, Joel Mall 7, since he was injured for a long time. And we also have the most penalties scored. Munas Dabur, 5 out of 5. He have been very solid for us this season. Super important. Yellow cards, we have 23 of them. That is... well, I guess that's fine. We are still in the lead, so we can take a few extra red, yellow cards. Red cards, we only have 1. But we won that match, so it was fine. It was Sigurd Jonsson. Goals scored, we are the best team at scoring so far. Without Munas Dabur, we would be a lot lower in this list, I feel. But we have him at least for the rest of this season. See, we are not doing very well with crosses. Not sure what that is. Maybe that is because our only wingers are our defenders. So that might be a cause of it. Crosses completed 49. Quite low in that list as well. But our focus is more attacking through the middle, and it's been working well for us. Goals from corners, we have 4 of them. Nice to see that. No goals from direct free kicks, but indirect free kicks, we have 4 goals. Pass completion ratio, we're actually 3rd in the league. I did not expect that, but we're gonna take it. Very nice to see. We have 79% overall. Passes completed. We are also in 3rd place. Shots on target, we are in fourth place, but it's rather close. Fouls against, rather high up on that list. Dribbles per game, we are rather low, but that is to be expected since we do not have any offensive wingers, and I usually feel like those are the players that dribble the most. Tackles won ratio, we are actually worst in the league. Attendance, that is always interesting. We can see that we are not doing very well when it comes to attendance. Let's look at our facilities. We can take in 25,000, so only having a little more than 8,000 is, of course, not good. Very, very poor, actually. We can see we have 33% of capacity. We will need that to rise up quite a lot. Salary per annum, we are in fourth place, very far behind Basel, very far behind Young Boys. We should also have a look at how our other teams are doing. Under 21, only friendlies, but they have been doing very well. The under 18 team started very strong, but we can see now that the last three matches have not been good. So let's look what they are positioned. They are in second place. I think they were in lead at some point, but they have dropped down 7 points behind Basel now. So we have come to the end of this episode, also the end of the first half of the season. 18 matches played, that is half of the matches. We're gonna go into a almost 2 months long break, as I have mentioned before. See that we are not doing that well when it comes to money. We have been losing quite a lot of money this season. Hopefully we can turn that around. Maybe we need to sell some players in the January transfer window. Not sure who that would be, but it is something we need to consider to save our economy. We will see what happens. Until then, I'm Killer Cow Divine. Thank you all for watching.